Hi, everyone. It's Lisa Laflamme, and I just wanted to wish you and your families the very best of the festive season. I know 2020 has been a very difficult year for everybody. So here's to a brighter year ahead, a vaccine, 2021. It can't be worse than 2020. So wishing you a very merry, merry Christmas, a happy new year. And Brian, congratulations on the 100th episode. That, my friend, is a gift in itself. Merry Christmas.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the 100th episode of Tobin Tonight. Looks like we made it. Oh, I gotta be careful there. Don't want them to sue me. 100 episodes. I'm still just like, wow. I can't even grasp it. It's just mind blown. Anyways, huge thanks to Lisa Laflamme for the intro there. And I gotta agree with her. Let's hope 2021 is better than 2020, because 2020 was not like the vision itself. It sucked. So let's forget all about that and try to find some good things to remember, to celebrate around this time of year. Yes, I know we're in COVID, hashtag COVID Christmas, but let's try to find some good things that we can celebrate, look back on, and think it's not all doom and gloom. For example, what were some of your favorite Christmas pastimes or traditions you had as a kid or you still have to this day? Thank you, you asked me. That's so nice of you. Here I was thinking you didn't even care. My favorite Christmas pastime would be, like, you know, listening to Christmas music on the radio while decorating my room or the basement with Christmas stuff. It's kind of like making the place your own little winter wonderland. Walking in a winter wonderland. No record deal coming for me anytime soon. All right, that's enough for me. Let's check in on some of our past guests or past acts and see, you know, what they had to say.
Hey guys, it's Crystal from Sons of Daughters. Just wishing everybody a happy holidays and fingers crossed a happy new year for 2021. One of my favorite Christmas pastimes is driving around the neighborhood with my parents and my younger brother and sister, and we would ooh and awe over the wild Christmas displays and Christmas lights our neighborhood would put up. And also, my first niece was born on Christmas Eve on the 24th, so we get to celebrate her every year around Christmas too.
Hey, it's Jimmy from Sons of Daughters. I wanted to wish you all a Merry Christmas. From my family to yours, we hope you have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And I was asked what my favorite Christmas pastime would be. And it would definitely have to be, I remember as kids, we used to have to sit at the top of the stairs. We couldn't come down yet until everything was, I guess, in order to open the presents. And I remember smelling like, you know, you'd smell bacon and eggs cooking in the kitchen. We always used to do this classic kind of breakfast. And so I don't know, that was just like when I smelled that was like, okay, we're ready to open presents, and it was just such an exciting thing. So yeah, today, to this day, Christmas morning, I like to cook something like that and do the whole coffee, orange juice. I think it's called a continental breakfast, but I don't know, that kind of was always something that was special to me that we've continued on.
Hey, we're New Law. I'm Gabe.
I'm Ty.
And I'm Dane. And we're hoping that you and your family are really enjoying this festive season.
So, from our family to yours, we want to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Also, huge congrats to Tobin on reaching 100 episodes. That's such a huge accomplishment.
Our favorite Christmas tradition is playing hockey outside. We usually build a hockey rink just in the backyard over there. And to us, you really can't beat us going outside and playing hockey on Christmas morning.
And we challenge anybody to a 3-on-3. We're mainly looking at the Hunter Brothers. Draft well, because we're not playing all five.
Yeah, well, you won't take three. So.
And even then, we probably should only play one and still lose.
Anyways, to celebrate the Christmas season this year, we decided to release an original Christmas song, so we're going to play it for you now. This is called It's Christmas Time. One, two.
We sing joy to the world. Brings a smile to every little boy and girl. it's Christmas time.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
And a Happy New Year.
Now, see, doesn't that put you in the Christmas mood? You know, driving around, looking at Christmas lights, a new baby in the fold, opening gifts, or having a special Christmas breakfast, and yes, if you have the weather, creating an outdoor rink. But Nula, just a bit of advice, those Hunter brothers are tough. You may need to be playing some Gordie Howe type hockey. You know, some elbows, some slashing, some dirty tactics that don't really get noticed by the ref, or maybe they're even afraid to call it because it's Gordie freaking Howe. Thanks to Crystal, Jimmy, and the New Law Brothers for sharing their pastimes and that very, very Christmas song. Also, you know, check out Sons of Daughters' Christmas tune, Moonshine and Mistletoe. It's really, really good. Speaking of Christmas music, what's your favorite Christmas song? You know, right now I'm drawing a blank. I'm actually not quite sure, but hold on. Let me ask one of my friends and past guests. Sarah Wicked, what's your favorite Christmas tune?
Hey, this is Sarah Wicked, and I'm wishing you, your friends, and family a very Merry Christmas. My favorite Christmas song is Santa Baby, and congratulations on 100 episodes, Tobin. That is amazing.
Thank you, Sarah. I actually forgot about Santa Baby. There's a lot of renditions of that song. But you did help me figure it out. My favorite Christmas song, without a doubt, is Wonderful Christmas Time by Paul McCartney. If it's not that, if we're going with something more recent, I mean very recent, it's probably Macklemore's with It's Christmas Time. Two different songs, two different types of songs, so don't think they're somewhat similar in any shape or form. So many musicians have great songs and great Christmas songs, including our next one, friend of the podcast as well, Chloe Caroline. Take it away, Chloe.
Hey, this is Chloe Caroline, just wishing you and your family a very Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. I'm out here in Southern California where it's nice and warm, and I hope you guys are staying safe and warm by the fire wherever you are. This is my new single called Got Me Believing on Tobin Tonight.
Been a while since I felt some magic. You got me all.
It just wouldn't be a Tobin Tonight Christmas without "Twas the Night Before Christmas," performed by some of our past guests. Enjoy.
"'Twas the night before Christmas when, all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there.
The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap.
When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprung from the bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash.
The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When to my wandering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer.
With a little old driver, so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name.
Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all.
As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with the sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too.
And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my hand and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack.
His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow.
The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf. And I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself. A wink of his eve and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread.
He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work, and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, to his team he gave a whistle, and away they all flew, like the down of a thistle. But I heard him explain, ere he drove out of sight,
Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Between you and me, I think that's one of the best bits that we've had. Not just for Christmas, but like all time on this show. Just look at the acts that we got to do their own version of "'Twas the Night Before Christmas." Peter Mansbridge, Rick Mercer, Lisa LaFlamme, James Duthie, James Sabalski, William Daniels, Brighton James, the list goes on and on. It's crazy that we got them to do that. A big shout out, a big thanks for them to do that. Now, you heard some of our other acts talk about their favorite Christmas pastimes, their favorite traditions. You heard mine. But there's more to Christmas than just some pastimes. You know, when you turn on the TV, there's Christmas movies. Like, what's some of your favorite Christmas movies? What's a favorite Christmas gift that you received? Me, personally, my favorite Christmas movie of all time is How the Grinch Stole Christmas. Not the cartoon version, the Jim Carrey version. I remember seeing it in theaters and I was just blown away by it. And even for this year, for Christmas, I've got the 20-year anniversary DVD. I don't know why. Like, it's basically the same movie. Maybe they have a few more special features, but that movie was just mind-blowing. Loved it. Loved Jim Carrey's performance in it. If you've caught up with my Instagram social media posts, you've seen that I've been posting a few of my favorite Christmas gifts. I'm a big wrestling fan, so anything involving wrestling, wrestlers, a punching bag that's kind of like a wrestler, they were always my all-time favorites. Getting an NHL 2002 and a PlayStation 2, amazing times. I toss across. There's so many great gifts out there, but that's enough about me. Like, come on, I'm the host. Like, come on, you're supposed to plug the guests. And you're right, totally gonna do that. So here are some other acts and what their favorite Christmas gift or movie was. Take it away, James.
Hey guys, it's James Duffy. Just wanted to wish y'all a Merry Christmas and a Happy Holidays. I'm out in Edmonton for the World Juniors, currently in quarantine, watching The Bachelorette. That's how pathetic my life is. Favorite Christmas movie, Elf, no contest. And congrats, Tobin, on 100 episodes. Take it easy, guys.
Hey, it's Sally Sharp from Mono Wales, and I want to wish all your friends and your family and you a Happy Holidays. My favorite movie during this time of year is Jingle All the Way because it is jokes. Make sure you check it out if you haven't. It's a classic 90s movie. And of course, congrats on your 100th episode, Tobin. You're killing it. Have a great day, guys. Everyone.
It's Flash.
And Boots. And we just want to wish you and your family a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
One of my favorite presents I ever got was actually just time. More so than ever, I love spending time with my family and singing with them. So that's my favorite.
That's nice. That's a good one for this year, too. And, spending time with the people you love. We love you, and congratulations on 100 episodes, that's awesome. Tobin. That's amazing. Bye, everyone. Bye. Merry Christmas.
Hey, what's up? It's Rachel Cousins wishing you and your family a very holly jolly Christmas. My favorite gift I ever received at Christmas is definitely my Taylor GS mini guitar. I still use it to this day for every gig, and it definitely sparked a lot of songwriting for me when I first got it. It was a guitar that I wanted for years, so you can imagine it was a dream come true. Congrats on 100, Tobin, and here is my song, Under the Tree, on Tobin Tonight's Christmas special.
Hot chocolate, sit down and then we'll take a sip. Oh, this feels so right under Christmas lights. Put a record on, dancing through the night. Cause Santa's coming to town and the snow is falling down. Oh, I'm feeling the cheer, seeing the magic now that you're here. Kiss me goodnight,
amazing job there, Rachel. Now what's not amazing is James watching The Bachelorette, but I guess that's life in the Edmonton bubble. And yes, I too enjoy Jingle All the Way, Sally. Arnold, he's looking for a toy. He's looking for the hottest toy. Arnold. That's probably the worst Arnold Schwarzenegger impression ever. I can't remember the toy that he was looking for. I believe it's like a Captain... It kind of reminds me of like a Captain America or like an Avengers. It was like red and gold or something. Something of that nature. Totally off the top of my head right now. It was definitely, though... You know what? It was definitely the PS5. Or an OMG doll. Right? Am I right, though? Oh, those memories of wanting the hottest toy item and just really hoping, praying that you got it. Whether it be a Furby, Sock and Boppers, whatever it really was. You know? Yeah, it's weird to look back at it, but I'm sure you have one in mind that you were like, oh my god, if I don't get this for Christmas, it's the hottest item, I better get this. Hey, Izzy, what was your favorite Christmas memory?
Hey, it's Isabel Ritchie from the Strumbellas, and I'm wishing you and your friends and family a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. One of my favorite Christmas memories is I was lighting a fire and gathering around it to open our presents and stockings. I hope that you make some great Christmas memories this year, too.
Ooh, that's a good one. Here are some past guests sharing their Christmas memories.
Decorating a Christmas tree with my grandma, and she always had this tiny little bird decoration that she'd put on the tree, and every year she'd put it on the tree before I got to her house, and then I'd have to find it, and I just absolutely loved it.
Hey there, I'm Lindsay Hamilton, and I want to wish anyone listening to this a very Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. And my favorite Christmas memory, I could go the nostalgic route, but I'm sure you've heard that plenty of times before. So instead of sharing a memory that could warm your heart, I'm choosing one that may make you feel cold, because I sure was on Christmas Eve many years ago, sitting in the snow on my front lawn watching firefighters enter my home. I was just a kid. My family and I spent Christmas Eve together, doing all the classic final preparations, putting the cookies out for Santa, enjoying a nice family fire together, until all of a sudden our eyes started to water. No, not from tears of Christmas Eve joy. We realized it was due to smoke in the family room. My dear father had forgotten to open the flue in the fireplace, so smoke was billowing into the house instead of out the chimney, and the smoke got so bad we all had to put on our snowsuits, 10, 11 o'clock that night, sit out on the front lawn and watch firefighters show up to our house and try to suck up some of the smoke. So, suffice to say, one of the most memorable Christmas Eves, and in many ways, shades of a National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. All you needed was a Clark Griswold sighting.
Hey, this is Chloe Caroline, just wishing you and your family a very Merry Christmas. My favorite memory is going to my grandmother's house in Hilton Head Island, South Carolina. She lived on a golf course, and we would take my grandfather's golf cart and go Christmas caroling around the neighborhood. It was so much fun. All my cousins were there. All my family was there, and we would fly from California just to spend time with them. So that's my favorite memory.
Hey everybody, this is James Duffy from TSN. Just wanted to wish you all a very, very Merry Christmas, all of the Tobin Tonight listeners, and please spend part of your holidays watching the World Juniors, because if you don't, I'll be lonely. If I can make it like an overall memory, my sisters, I have two older sisters, 4 and 6 years older than me, and they tormented me in a loving way, and so every Christmas they would make it really hard to find my gift, and that was the thing they did every year. It was like a treasure hunt. And they went to incredibly elaborate means of doing that. For instance, one year at the cottage, they buried my present in a plastic container in the lake. And so this is the advanced planning. They put it in there in like October. And so the lake froze over, and I had to take an ice pick and dig for an hour through the lake to get my present. Another time, they laid fishing line through the entire house. So basically, like hundreds of
yards of fishing line that I had to follow upstairs, downstairs, through every bedroom, only to find that my present was underneath the tree. They were evil geniuses, as I said, and those are the memories I make. It's always waiting. They always gave me a great gift, too, but it was 2 hours to find it.
Hey, everybody. This is Rick Campanelli wishing you all a Merry Christmas. Have a fun time with your family and friends, and don't drink too much eggnog. So I come from a pretty big family. I'm the youngest of four. Very close-knit Italian family, a lot of relatives. So one of my favorite memories from being a kid was getting together with the rest of, the family members, the cousins, the uncles, the aunts, my Nono, my Nona back in the day. And, you know, when you're young, everything just seems so magical. Well, that's what it was like for us, you know, visiting family, exchanging gifts, feasting on turkey, and whatever else we were feasting on. But yeah, favorite memory for sure is that, followed closely by all the old black and white classic Christmas shows that came on once a year back then. Now we've got them all on our mobile devices, and I could watch them in July if I wanted. But back then it was so magical because we anxiously waited for the James Stewart It's a Wonderful Life. So yeah, those are my my favorite memories.
Merry Christmas from Colin Mockery. Here's my favorite Christmas memory. When I was about 10, my parents were in financial difficulty. My dad couldn't find work, so it was a pretty bleak Christmas. But the local church brought over a lot of gifts and food for us to get through the holiday. I only got one gift that year, and it was a hockey stick, and that was the most important present I ever had. It also taught me about how to give not only at Christmas, but hopefully throughout the year, and help people whenever you can. So everyone, have a great Christmas. Happy holidays. Have fun.
Those are all some great Christmas memories, and hopefully someday we can get back to doing those Christmas traditions, pastimes, and memories with our loved ones. That's going to do it for this episode of Tobin Tonight, the 100th episode, and I just want to thank all the guests that ever came on with our episode 1 to 100, whether you helped out in this podcast in any way. Thank you so much for the people that listen, share it, whether you started off at episode 1, 90, or if this is your first episode, thanks for being on board. I know 2020 may have been a terrible year, a crappy year all around. You might not been able to play the sports you wanted, interact with your friends, go to pubs, go to sporting events. And now even at Christmas time, it becomes a lot more obvious when you're not with your friends, with your families, to do everything that we've basically said in this podcast. But keep in mind, we can still do small things that can still leave a big impact. You know, call them up, give them a Zoom chat, send them a card, ask them how they're doing, have a general, deep conversation with somebody. I know that sounds like a small, mediocre thing that doesn't mean much, but believe me, it would go a long way. Let's hope, though, in 2021 we can look back at this and appreciate what we maybe took for granted at this time, because, you know, I know personally, I miss seeing my buddies, I miss giving them Christmas cards and just having a laugh or talking about little things that we may have done during that week. So for me and my family, here's to wishing you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. You turn on How the Grinch Stole Christmas, Miracle on 34th Street, go listen to some Christmas music, and decorate your house if you can, anything to put you in the Christmas spirit. To close us out, to take us home, the one, the only, the Newfoundland legend himself, the guy who loves to rant, except in this case, Rick Mercer.
Hello, Tobin Tonight fans. Rick Mercer here, wishing you all a very happy Christmas and a wonderful new year. Here's hoping that the new year brings us all closer together, literally. I wish you all a future that includes close-up, safe, and sloppy encounters with friends and strangers.